Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name's Rowan and today we are going to be unboxing the Illumicrate March box. So back to some more bookish content. This week I've been really, really busy with uni. In fact, even today I should be doing an essay right now, but I'm going to do it after I film this video because I am too excited to open this box. I know what book is going to be in it and I'm just mega excited to see what Illumicrate have done with it, with sprayed edges, you know, special edition, stuff like that. So let's just get stuck in. Okay, so I've accidentally opened it upside down, but it was easier to open it that way. So the book is actually on the top, but I'm going to try and not look at it. So put that over there. And let's do the items first. So everything's upside down. I don't have the spoiler card because that's going to be at the bottom, but I think this month's theme was Fighting Spirit. Pretty sure it was. And the first thing I can see is a hoop, and it says, take what you will. And that's what the hoop looks like in the plastic. I'm assuming it's a pin hoop. I'm not a huge fan of art on pin hoops because you can't see the art when you put all the pins on it, so I kind of don't really see the point. It's nice art though. I'll try and see if I can find the spoiler card. Okay, I was right, it's Fighting Spirit. Pin hoop. Oh, it's inspired by the Court of Miracles. That's what this is inspired by, which I should have guessed really because of the thing in the middle. I really enjoyed the Court of Miracles. I like that book. It's like a Les Mis retelling, but not really. It's very loosely based on Les Mis. Really like that. So loud. Got a couple of, a quite a heavy necklace pendant. Inspired by Tea's Heart Glass from the Bone Witch series, which I haven't read yet, but I have all of them on Kindle. It's a very, very pretty necklace. Again, I'll try and get it to show you, but it's kind of hard in the plastic. I try and keep things in the plastic in case I don't want to keep them, so that I can just sell them on to other people if I don't like them. But I really like this actually. I could put it on right now, but I won't. Okay, next. We have a, I'm assuming this is the pin for the book. It is! And it says, she could choose what she fought for. Oh gosh, the zoom in like the thing on my camera is not great, but the writing is really small in there. I always like really like Stacey McAvoy Court's pins, they're amazing. She always somehow gets like them to be really clean and really like good art, but not too complicated, and they just look really, really good. Next we have, oh, a tote bag. And it's in my favourite colour, which is purple. And this is the art, you see. That's really pretty. Like insanely pretty. What the fuck? I actually can't get over that. That's amazing. That's really good. Oh yeah, I thought it might be. It's a Winter Night tote bag. So it's Vasya and Morozko from the Winter Night trilogy, which is starts off with the bear and the nightingale. This is one of my favourite things ever that I've got. This is so lovely. Like, I don't tend to use totes that much, but I do it for, like, when I go for, like, a small shop or something. I really like this. Oh! Ooh! It's a snake wrapped around a dagger, and it's a wooden bookmark. Oh, it's very flimsy, though. It's very thin. Oh, inspired by Kingdom of the Wicked, which is another book that I haven't read yet, but I have the Fairy Loot edition and I'm looking to get to it soon. Like all of us, like everyone, we have never-ending TBRs and I have not been able to get to it yet, but this is quite pretty. Really like that. Nice. And the last item. Yes. Unfortunately, this is one that I don't like the fandom for. Oh, well, I haven't read the books. Dark Artifices by Cassandra Clare, which I think is the ones that's like Lady Midnight and Queen of Air and Darkness and stuff like that. But this is the artwork on it. A little bit blurry, but you can see. Again, it's such a pretty mug, but I just, I've collected almost all of the Rosie Thorne's mugs. I think the only one I don't have is the Cruel Prince one, because I didn't manage to get the box because I wasn't subscribed at the time. I didn't get the subscribers only early access, so I wasn't able to get the Queen of Nothing box, I think it was, unfortunately, which I'm actually really gutted about. These are always really good. I love the Rosy Thorns mugs, and I almost don't want to trade them away because I like knowing that I have all of them. But that is the capitalist in me. Okay, so that was it for the items. So now we can get to the book. Now this month, I don't know why, but like the Aluminum Crate box that usually is yellow. I don't know if this box is slightly bigger. Maybe they needed a slightly bigger box for the amount of items, but also the book has not come in the usual drawstring bag, but I'm not sure what's happened. But anyway, this month's book is The Unbroken by C.L. Clarke, which I'm going to unwrap right now. God, it's huge. This is a really big hardback, which I like. I really love tall hardbacks. I get really annoyed when in like book boxes, and I think it's not book boxes' fault because it does tend to be specific to the UK. Like the UK does have really short, really small hardbacks for some reason, but this is huge and I love it. And red sprayed edges, or like a maroony red, and that really fits the cover, I feel. Like I really think it really fits in. Obviously the inside of the dust jacket is the same color as the sprayed edges, which is lush. It's signed, which is lovely. And the sign page comes after. I literally just read, "Sky above and earth below. Where was she? Other than fucked." I cannot wait to read this book. It's an adult fantasy. I know it's a military fantasy set in North Africa. It's a debut as well, and thankfully I've seen loads and loads of hype for this on Twitter. I'm really, really excited to read it. It's one of my most anticipated. Probably this and The Jasmine Throne by Tasha Suri are like two of my most anticipated books for this year. So I'm likely to drop absolutely everything and just read this. And I'm pretty sure this is a, like, some kind of royal or person and personal guard type romance, and I'm pretty sure it's sapphic as well. So I can't wait. I may do a reading vlog for this, literally just because it's one of my most anticipated. And it's quite long. Oh, it's 488 pages. Oh, and then there's extras. There's extras in the back. Oh, it's Orbit. Ugh. Do you know what? Like Orbit and Tor, I think, are probably my favourite publishers. They just come out with, like, everything they come out is just a swing and a hit. Every single book. I just can't wait to read this. Look at her arms. Look at her muscly arms. That's it for this video, everyone. Nice quick short unboxing for you, for me to try and get some content out to you. I feel like you haven't seen my face in too long to do with bookish stuff, so I thought I'd get this out as soon as possible, and my box arrived today, so this is the perfect opportunity. Hopefully you will see me again very soon. I do have a little reading vlog currently ongoing for the Wayward Children series, and I also do have a video talking about Every Heart a Doorway in general, which will be out soon, hopefully next week. I just need to edit it. And then other than that, I hope that you have enjoyed this video. I hope you've enjoyed seeing all of the items. Let me know which one's your favourite, to be honest. Like, I can't get past the book. The book is probably my favourite thing for this box. To do with the items, my favourite is definitely this tote bag with Vasya Morozko on. Just the colours on this and the art, it's just amazing. I'm going to read out some of the artists now. So obviously, if you know Aluminum Crate, you know that the mugs are always by Rosy Thorns. The dagger mark is by Stacey McAvoy-Caunt, as well as the monthly pin. The necklace is by No One Designs, and the pin hoop is by Forensic Sandflowers, who I follow on Instagram. They're a really good artist. And the tote bag, which is actually my favourite item, is by afterblossom_art on Instagram. Her name's Kelly Chong. But yeah, thank you for joining me, and hopefully I will see you again soon. Bye!